GoPro cameras have been my go-to action cams over the past 7 years to record my travels, and I even use them on professional shoots. The main reason for that is the unrivaled quality that GoPro is able to pull out of these tiny sensors, and the GoPro Hero 10 is no exception. But I was a bit skeptical at first, so I did some comparisons that I want to share with you in this video, and at the end of the video I will also share my best GoPro Hero 10 video settings with you, so let's get started. The reason why I was skeptical when I saw the specs of the GoPro Hero 10 was that the high frame rates in 4K and 5.3K still get saved in the same codec that's already used by the Hero 9. And that usually means lower quality, but let's see if that's actually the case. At first I compared 5.3K and 30 frames per second on both cameras, and also the 5.3K 30 frames per second on the Hero 9 with 60 frames per second of the Hero 10, and I can't find a big difference. The GoPro Hero 10 seems to hold up slightly better when I color grade it strong, but not to a degree that anyone would notice it after uploading it to YouTube. The colors are also identical on both cameras when you shoot in the flat color profile, so I can always recommend shooting in 5.3K on both GoPros and in all frame rates. In 4K 24 and 60 frames per second, there is also not a big difference. The Hero 10 has a little bit of banding in the sky, while the Hero 9 does not, but therefore the Hero 9 shows more artifacting in the sky. But both don't really jump into the eyes, so it's all good here on both cameras. The 4K 120 frames per second footage of the Hero 10 has a bit brighter sky at the edges compared to the 4K 60 footage of the Hero 9, but apart from that, the footage looks identical as well. In 2.7K I notice a big difference in sharpness compared to all the 4K and 5K footage on both cameras, and the artifacting in the sky and on the water has greatly increased. Surprisingly, the GoPro Hero 9 shows a bit more detail on the mountains in the background, and that's the same compared to the 120p and 240p footage. But overall, especially the 240p footage of the Hero 10 comes out much better as expected. It's not perfect, but the 2.7K high frame rate options on both cameras are definitely usable. Now, the problem with highly compressed footage from action cameras is usually that it doesn't hold up well when you color grade it. And that was something I was really worried about for the 4K 120 and 5.3K 60 footage from the Hero 10. But I was really surprised when I actually tried it. As you can see here, even when I do super heavy color grades that you would usually not do, the footage holds up really good. I don't understand how GoPro does that, to be honest, but this company has really figured out their codecs. I don't know any tiny smartphone sensor camera that produces such a good video quality, and by the way, this video is not sponsored and I paid the full price for both GoPros. So, from all these tests, I can only say that you should stick to 5.3K resolution as much as possible, because it gives you overall the most detailed and good looking image. But if your computer can't handle 5K, then it's also perfectly fine to shoot in 4K. The difference is not huge. And also, if you want this crazy 5 or 10 times slow motion, then it's also fine to shoot in 4K 120 or 2.7K 240. Image is a bit softer then, but it still looks really nice, and if you add a little bit of sharpening and post, it actually looks pretty similar to the others as well. I just have the problem that I'm a 24p shooter, and GoPro for whatever reason did not include 24p in 5.3K resolution right now. Thank you, GoPro. And I also won't use the GoPro Hero 10 with my FPV drone that much for now, because I usually need 4:3 aspect ratio, 4K and 24 frames per second, which is also not available, so I will use my GoPro Hero 9 for that. Okay, enough comparisons, let's come to my video settings, which are pretty much the same as other GoPros. First, you set the resolution and frame rate that you need, so as mentioned before, that should be 5.3K or 4K as much as possible, and you only change the frame rate depending on if you want slow motion or not. Then either set your lens to wide or linear in case you don't want that wide angle look, both are fine. And I set hyper smooth to a high but not to boost, because boost acts a bit weird sometimes. Zoom is also important, always keep that to 1x, because otherwise the GoPro crops and you lose quality. And then under ProTune, you set the bitrate to high and shutter to auto, except when you use ND filters. And then EV compensation to negative 0.5, because that helps you to protect your highlights, so it's less likely that clothes or so get burnt out. The next setting is white balance, and that has to be set depending on the conditions. If you just get started, leave it to automatic, but otherwise you can set it to 6500 for cloudy days and 5500 for sunny days. Then I keep ISO min and max at 100, because higher ISO levels mean more noise, and I never use GoPros in low light situations, so I don't need higher ISOs to make the image brighter. And the last few settings, I set sharpness to low, because otherwise the video looks too digital, and I set my color profile to flat, because that gives me the most dynamic range. And I keep and set raw audio and wind to off, because the wind suppression just makes the whole audio unusable. You can set the shortcuts as you like, but my suggestion is to have the white balance somewhere in the shortcuts to be able to change that quickly. And for more tips on the GoPro Hero 10, also check out my Hero 9 videos, because what counts for the Hero 9 also counts for the 10. It's pretty similar cameras overall, so check that out. And I also have an online masterclass about GoPro cameras. You will find the link in the description below. But let's also talk about issues with the GoPro Hero 10. One of the biggest issues with the Hero 9 was the lagginess of the screen, and there were also occasional crashes. But so far on the Hero 10 that seems to be solved, the screen is super responsive and I didn't have any hangups so far, which is likely due to the new GP2 chip. But that doesn't mean that the Hero 10 is perfect, even if it's close. And my personal biggest issue is actually what I mentioned before already, the 24 frames per second missing in 5.3K and 4:3 aspect ratio, so unless I need 5.3K 60 frames per second, this resolution is unusable for me, for now at least. But some people also seem to have overheating issues with GoPros and the GoPro Hero 10, and to be honest, I never had any overheating problems with any GoPro, but that's because I never shoot that long with small cameras like that. But Roma, a friend of mine, did some tests that I will link here, like he made a video, and he found that the Hero 10 shuts off a bit quicker due to overheating as the Hero 9 does. But again, it's practically not an issue, because who shoots 20 minutes in a row with these cameras? Also worth mentioning here is that the battery drains quickly. If you shoot in 4K 120 and generally higher frame rates and resolutions, I noticed that when I got some shots with my FPV drone, because there the GoPro was recording for a bit longer, and the battery definitely drained quicker as usual. So only shoot in high frame rates if needed. I also got the question a lot how the battery life is when you shoot time lapses. And when you do that, the battery actually lasts for many hours, because it turns the screen off and it only takes single photos instead of an actual video. So I think my longest time lapse was about 2 or 3 hours long, and there was still a good amount of battery left. If you want to shoot for a whole day or so, you can also connect a power bank. And if you want to know more about shooting time lapses with GoPros, click the video here in the corner. There you will learn everything you need to know about that. And also, if you like this video, leave me a thumbs up and consider subscribing.